गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे क्लास हाइब्रिड्स। ऑल एलिमेंट्स इन द पीरियडिक टेबल एक्सेप्ट नोबल गैसेस कंबाइन विद द हाइड्रोजन एलिमेंट टू फॉर्म बाइनरी कंपाउंड्स। दैट बाइनरी कंपाउंड्स इज कॉल्ड हाइब्रिड्स। ओवरऑल ऑल एलिमेंट्स लाइक मेटल्स, non-metals, these all elements reacts with the hydrogen to form their hybrids. But noble gases, which elements are noble gases? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. These elements does not react with the hydrogen, do not form hybrids. Okay, so overall, so number of hydrates are there. Suppose for example, NH3, it is nitrogen is the non-metal. Okay, so NH3, nitrogen hydride, or it is ammonia. Or suppose CH4, carbon hydride, it is methane. Okay. Suppose B2H6, boron hydride, it is diborane. So suppose BH2, B is the metal. This metal to form their hydride, BH2, beryllium hydride. Okay, so there are all different types of hydrides, but noble gases do not form their hydrides. Overall, hydrides is classified into three types. How many types? Three types. Number one, ionic hydrides. Okay, number one, ionic hydrides. And second one, covalent hydrides. Third one, metallic hydrides. Okay, overall hydrides is classified into three types. Number one, ionic hydrides. Number two, covalent hydrides. Number three, metallic hydrides. Now we have discussed about ionic hydrides. Overall, ionic hydrides is also called self. Overall, hydrides is classified into three types, that is ionic, covalent and metallic hydrides. So now we are discussing about ionic hydrides. So ionic hydrides is also called saline hydrides, or it is also called stoichiometric hydrides. Stoichiometric hydrides means balancing hydrides. Okay, so non-stoichiometric hydrides means non-balancing hydrides. Okay, so overall stoichiometry means balancing equations. Okay, so stoichiometric hydrides means balancing hydrides. Okay, overall, so these ionic hydrides is formed by highly positive nature of S black elements combined with the hydrogen to form their hydrides. Okay, so highly electro positive nature of S black elements combine with the hydrogen to form ionic hydrides. Okay, so overall already we know that S black elements contain two groups, that is first A and second A group. So first A group elements like lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Also for secondary group elements, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium or radium. So they are all S black elements. Overall, they are all elements to form their hydrides. Like a suppose for example, LiH, lithium hydride, or NaH, sodium hydride, or KH, potassium hydride, or RbH, rubidium hydride. So they are all hydrides. Next further, suppose we have taken second A group elements. Suppose BeH2, beryllium hydride, or MgH2, magnesium hydride, or CaH2, calcium hydride, or SrH2, strontium hydride, or suppose BaH2, barium hydride. So these are all ionic hydrides. Okay, they are all ionic hydrides. Listen, so S block elements to give ionic hydrides. S block elements contain two groups, that is first A and second A, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. So they are all elements first A group. Second A group elements like a beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. So overall, they are all elements to form their hydrides like LiH, NaH, or BH2, MgH2, CH2. So overall, these ionic hydrides is all crystalline components. Okay, crystals at the same time, solid compound. Crystals is like a solids. Okay, all crystalline solid components, and their all components is a non-volatile components. Okay, do not that it is converted to vaporization, vapor. Okay, so non-volatile components, and at the same time, their all components is a converted to ions. Suppose for example BeH2, beryllium hydride. This beryllium hydride, it is converted to Be+2 and 2H-. Be+2 and 2H-. So one positive ion and second negative ion. So overall, ionic hydrides must contain positive and negative ion, that is Be+2 positive ion, second one 2H- negative ion. These are 2H- negative ion in the melt position. So it is give the hydrogen gas and to give 2 electrons. Okay, these are 2H- hydride ion. It is converted to H2 plus 2 electrons. Okay, so it is a reaction with they are all hydride reaction with the number of components. So to give different types of compounds, suppose for example like a NaOH, NaH, sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydride, NaH. This sodium hydride is reaction with the water molecule to form their hydroxide. Okay, suppose it is reaction with the H2O. To form this reaction, NaOH and a hydrogen gas. Okay, H2, and NaOH, sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Remaining, suppose LiH, lithium hydride. sodium hydride is also reacts with the water molecule to form their LiOH, lithium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. At the same time, beryllium hydride or magnesium hydride, these components also reaction with the water molecule. Suppose MgH2, it reacts with the water molecule to form in this reaction MgOH taken twice and a hydrogen gas. Okay, magnesium hydride is reacts with the water molecule to form magnesium hydroxide and a hydrogen gas. Okay, so alcoholic metal hydrides and alcoholic F2 metal hydrides easily reaction with the water molecules to form their hydroxide and a hydrogen gas. Okay, so overall it is also these all hydrides is mainly used for to preparation of another hydrides also. Suppose for example, suppose LiH, lithium hydride. This lithium hydride is react with the Al2Cl6, aluminium chloride. To form in this reaction, overall LiAlH4. So LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride. At the same time, in this reaction, to form LiCl, lithium chloride. Okay, so lithium hydride is reacts with the aluminium chloride Al2Cl6 to give LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride and a hydrogen lithium chloride. Suppose LiH, lithium hydride. This lithium hydride is reacts with the B2H6. So it is a diborane. The time to form LiBH4, lithium boro tetrahydride. Okay, so lithium hydride reacts with the diborane to form LiBH4. At the same time, replace of lithium hydride, we have taken NaH also, sodium hydride. Suppose sodium hydride is reacts with the diborane, so our boron hydride B2H6, to form this reaction 2NaBH4. Okay, 2NaBH4. So it is a ionic hydrate. Listen, S black elements, highly positive nature of S black elements to form ionic hydrates. So overall, ionic hydrates is also called stoichiometric hydrates or saline hydrates. Stoichiometric means balancing. Okay, balanced hydrates. Overall, S black elements contain first and second group elements. So the first and second group elements hydrates, lithium hydride, sodium hydride or beryllium hydride or magnesium hydride. So they are all hydrates, crystalline solid components and non-volatile components. Overall, they are all hydrides mainly reaction with water molecules to form their hydroxides and hydrogen gas. Suppose, for example, lithium hydride reaction with water molecules to form lithium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Beryllium hydride is also reaction with the water molecules to form their hydroxide and hydrogen gas. At the same time, lithium hydride is to give another hydride. Okay, these hydrides is give another hydrides. When lithium hydride is reacts with the Al2Cl6 aluminium chloride to form lithium aluminium hydride, LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, at the same time lithium chloride, lithium hydride reacts with the boron hydride or diborane. It is also to form lithium borohydride. So sodium hydride is also reacts with the diborane to form 2NaBH4. Okay, so it is the ionic hydride. Next, further, second one, covalent hydride. So covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides is also called molecular hydrides. Covalent hydrides is also called molecular hydrides. Overall, p black elements to give covalent hydrides. So p black elements, like just like a 13th group or 14th group, 15, 16, 17, but except noble gases. Okay, so p black elements 13 to 18, already we know that. From 13 to 17th group elements to form their covalent hydrides. So overall, noble gases do not form hydrides, already we know that. So 13th 14th 15th 16th 17th group elements to form covalent hydrides or molecular hydrides. So overall, metals and non-metals, p black elements contain metals and non-metals. Like suppose aluminium is a metal. Okay, so gallium, indium, thallium is the metal. Suppose we have phosphorus is the non-metal, sulfur is the non-metal, carbon is the non-metal, nitrogen also. So metals and non-metals to give molecular hydrides or covalent hydrides. Suppose, for example, nitrogen, p black element, carbon, p black element, or suppose for example chlorine, p black element, so or oxygen, p black element, they are all non metals. Or suppose aluminium is a metal, okay, thallium is a metal, or gallium is a metal. Overall, these non-metals reacts with hydrogen to form their hydrides. Suppose oxygen to give H2O, water molecules, oxygen hydride. Or suppose nitrogen is to give NH3, nitrogen hydride. It is ammonia, already we know that. Carbon is to give CH4, carbon hydride, that is methane. Or chlorine is give HCl, hydrochloric acid. Okay, so overall, they all elements non-metal hydrides. Okay, so metal hydrides also are there in this p black. Overall, Covalent hydrides are molecular hydrides. Covalent hydrides are molecular hydrides is classified into three types. Number one, electron deficient hydrides. Okay, so electron deficient hydrides are electron precious hydrides are electron rich or more hydrides. Okay, covalent hydrides are molecular hydrides classified into three types. Number one, electron deficient hydrides. Second one, electron precious hydrides. Third one, electron rich hydrides. So overall, these hydrides we are discuss further class. What is electron deficient hydrides? What is rich hydrides? We are discuss further class. Okay.